Good morning, second grade. Ms. Fogelman here for your writing lesson today. Let me share my screen. All right, so we have been talking about poetry during writing, and we've actually been writing some poetry. Today, we're going to talk about patterning through repetition. Repetition, of course, means using the same words over and over, using, you can also do patterning like rhyming words, things like that, to give your poems some rhythm. So to start with our teaching point today, I want to teach you that poets repeat things, words, sounds, and lines to give their poems music and to make the meaning of their poems more clear. So I am going to show you this Go Noodle video to give you an idea of what repetition means. And before I do, let me check my volume to make sure you guys can hear it. All right, so.
Banana.
Banana.
Meatball.
Yeah.
turn it up.
Nerdy by nature.
Turn it up.
Patterns in the air. Patterns everywhere. Patterns made of shapes. Patterns made of grapes. Yeah. Patterns on the cheetah. Patterns on my feeder. Patterns in the nap. Patterns in this rap. Oh.
That's right.
Make a pattern. Make a pattern. Let's make a pattern. All right.
Cool.
Make a pattern. Make a pattern. Let's make a pattern. Okay. Here's one. Banana. Banana. Meatball. 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 Banana. Banana. Meatball.
You got it.
Turn it up now. Make a pattern. Make a pattern. Let's make a pattern. All right. Make a pattern, make a pattern, let's make a pattern. Okay, here's one. Nod, clap, shake your hips. 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 Nod, clap, shake your hips.
Bring it back.
Come on, y'all.
Make a pattern, make a pattern, let's make a pattern. All right. Make a pattern, make a pattern, let's make a pattern. Okay, here's one. Loud, loud, quiet, quiet. 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 Loud, loud, quiet, quiet.
Patterns when I walk, patterns when I talk. Patterns in my brain, patterns down the drain. Patterns on my nail, patterns on the snail. Patterns on the walls going straight into my eyeball.
Labs and zigzags, stripes and spots, spirals, tiles, tater tots.
Oh.
Everywhere I look, these patterns emerge, and then I start to get this funny urge
to make a pattern. Make a pattern, let's make a pattern. All right. Make a pattern, make a pattern, let's make a pattern. Okay, last one. Elbow, stomach, stomach, elbow, 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 elbow, stomach, stomach, elbow.
Patterns in the air, patterns everywhere, patterns made of shapes, patterns made of grapes, patterns on the cheetah, patterns on my feeder, patterns in the nap, patterns in this rack.
One more time.
Yeah, make a pattern, make a pattern, let's make a pattern. All right. Make a pattern, make a pattern, let's make a pattern.
I'm like totally obsessed with patterns.
Oh yeah.
My nickname's actually Pattern.
Anywhere you look, you can see a pattern and pointing right out. Just gotta be paying attention.
Wanna go full Go
okay.
Noodle?
So that gives you an idea of what a pattern is and how it gives your songs or poetry some rhythm. As you could see in that video, the repetition gave some rhythm to their song, and it can give rhythm to your poetry too. All right, so here's an example. This is called Go Wind, and it's by Lillian Moore. Go wind blow, push wind swoosh, shakes things, takes things, makes things fly. Ring things, swing things, fling things high. Go wind blow, push things we. No wind, no, not me, not me. So let's think about this. What types of things are giving this poem some rhythm, some repetition, some just more, I guess all I can say is more rhythm. Okay, so go wind blow, push wind swoosh, shakes things, takes things, makes things fly. Well, you can hear that they're repeating the word things, okay? So it's making it very shakes things, takes things, makes things fly. Ring things, swing things, fling things high. Go wind blow, push things wee. This word even gives some of it some rhythm. No wind, no, not me, not me. Okay, so there's a lot of repetition in this poem, and it really gives it more of a rhythm, and many times people are more interested in reading poems if they have that rhythm, that repetition within the poem. All right, so let me clear my drawings. All right, so in Go Wind by Lillian Moore, we have our first stanza, or if you remember, we've talked about how stanzas are like paragraphs in writing, okay? So we have our first stanza right here. Then we have a line break. Then we have our second stanza, and then a line break, and our third stanza. And as we could see in each stanza, there is repetition. All right, so make meaning with music, okay? So when you have that rhythm in your poetry, it's like making music. Use patterns and repetition of sounds, words, and lines. Okay, so ring things, swing things, fling things high. Okay, that's repetition, okay? Patterns would be like splish, splash, splosh. I'm sorry. Splish, splash, splosh. Splish, splash, splosh. Okay, that's a pattern. You're repeatedly saying each word. Splish is the first word, splash is the second, splosh is the third. All right, so poetry, decisions that strengthen meaning. All right, today I would like for you to write some new poems. I want you to get a fresh piece of paper. I want you to really think about something that you could write about that would lend itself to repetition and patterning, okay? Even sounds, words, okay? So things like wee, or if you're talking about a cow, you might say moo. Sounds that will give that reader a more, a much better picture of what's going on, okay? So experiment today with patterns and repetition that add music to your poems. So make sure you're choosing a topic where you think you can really use that. All right, that's it for today. Please make sure you're getting that work done. In Shobee, you're working on a new poem. Make sure you're putting it into the writing folder.